Exiles, hear me now. We are the squeezing coils of history, grinding stone and dynasty to dust. We are the devouring serpent. We are.
Hey everyone, Garnet here from our Garnet. In today's video I show you the bosses I farm in the Unnamed City for Fragments of Power. I also grab some easy chests that contain fragments as well. Me personally, I would not recommend farming all the chests for fragments. It involves a lot of climbing and climbing is too fucking buggy in this game. They're also not guaranteed spawns, so you might end up spending hours climbing for nothing. Bosses on the other hand are a guaranteed spawn, and you can farm them the whole day. And kill all the bosses in the Unnamed City, then go out in the world, kill for example Scorpion Queen or the Black Yeti. They also drop fragments, and then when you come back to the Unnamed City you can farm the bosses again. I will not be going to the Scorpion Queen in this video because I'm too lazy. But why would you farm Fragments of Power? Well, let me show you. When you turn in a Fragment of Power, it will grant you a scroll of a random recipe. For example, Serpentman Statue, Dead Leg, stuff like that. So if you're a completionist, you wanna turn in the Fragments of Power until you have all the recipes. But the recipe we are after is this, Tablet of Power. So we're just gonna turn in Fragments of Power till we have this recipe. And if we get this recipe, we can then make a Tablet of Power. It will cost 5 Fragments of Power to make, and if you make it and use it, you get 60 extra knowledge points, which is pretty fucking amazing to be honest, so it's really recommended farming this as soon as possible. Bosses are pretty easy, so not much preparation is needed. I will show you the gear and weapons and build I use. Only if you're thinking about spending a substantial amount of time in the Unnamed City, I would recommend bringing multiple water flasks, as you will need to drink a lot there. So yeah, let's go kill some stuff. We are going to farm 7 bosses here. Brute, Guardian of the Flame, Commander, the White Bat Demon, the Watcher, the Grave Walker, and the Red Mother. I will show on the map where I am before each fight starts. So yeah, enjoy. Thank you. again. There's the obelisk. It's the same location where we learned the map room. As you can see, it says press E to interact. You have been granted a new scroll. Scroll Whirlwind Blades. So we turned in one fragment of power and we received the scroll. Learned Whirlwind Blades. I think there's like 28 something recipes you can learn. But you're gonna turn in fragments of power until you can make, until you get the recipe Tablet of Power. When you get that recipe, you can make it Tablet of Power. As you can see, you need 5 fragments of power, so we're gonna make that. Pay attention to my feed points, available 22, spent 545. Ooh, this actually goes slower than I would have thought. Just gonna admire this beautiful map room. Probably the coolest placeable I've seen so far in the game, to be honest. If anything new to say. Yeah, I'm not gonna buy that now. Because I'm in the middle of crafting, I don't want to lose my fragments. Yeah, if you spend, if you're planning on spending a substantial amount of time here, I would stack up on drinks. Because the water consumption goes through the roof here. Almost finished. Again. 22 points I have available. This is what I've spent. If I click Fragment of Power, you have gained feed points. Now I have 32 available. Now I click the Tablet of Power. You have gained feed points. Now I have 92 available. So yeah, it's really important that you get this, because now I can spend 92 points here that I usually could not spend here. So yeah, it's definitely worth farming these bosses, farming these fragments of power, and turning them in here to get all the recipes, but most importantly, get the recipe Tablet of Power. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and see you in the next one. Bye.